Hello, everybody. My name is Jos Westerbeke, and I'm from the Erasmus University in Rotterdam, in the Netherlands. I'm specialized in e-resource access. And I will present you the FIM4L initiative. We have now a Libre working group, and we'll show you why this why we start this initiative and why it is brought forward. So I will present my screen right now. Okay, great. So here's my contact information. I can share this presentation with you afterwards. My job is an IT specialist for libraries at the Erasmus University, and I'm a specialist in the e-resource access to all our the databases, publishers. We need to give access, and you will understand what needs to be in place to give access. So that's actually my job. And what we are seeing now is a shift in access models, and that's what we are looking at this moment. And we see a shift towards SSO access, and you know, that gives some privacy concerns for the library. And a library should have been a trusted place where you can do your research, and you know, in a trusted place, like in the old days, you have a building and you can go inside and no one is looking at you. But that's completely different in the online world. So we want to provide a private place also online. And the library is the organization, the institution who needs to protect its patrons. So what we like to have is a trusted place. And what we are seeing right now is a shift from IP to single sign-on. And that's because IP access is an old access method, and it's based on location. So an IP address is based on location. So publishers want to move away from IP-based authentication towards single sign-on authentication. And that's based on a person. So yeah, you need to log in with single sign-on, of course, but there the problems arise. So those questions we address this, and we are looking into the problems what comes with this new access method. And I'm sorry, I have to let in somebody. And then if we are talking about SSO, then we mean federated identity management, actually. So federated identity management is the working environment to provide access for all kind of publishers for the library. So what's important if we speak about federated identity management? As most of you know, you have identity providers and service providers. the identity provider here is always the library, if in our case, a research library, and publishers like Elsevier. There are many publishers, hundreds do we have as a library. So it's easy now if you give access based on IP address, because you have to register it one time and then it's okay. But to build up an SSO connection, it's much more difficult. So SSO is established between the identity provider and the service provider, but there are many federations in between. Often federations are in between, and they work together based on trust relationships. And that all makes it on one side a bit difficult, but on the other side, if configured correctly, it's also made easier to do if all configurations are rightly in place. And then we speak about authentication. The identity provider is the one who authenticates. So that's a really important thing for the library, because when you speak about authentication, you also have the part of provisioning. And I mean, what I mean with provisioning is that you need to share some information, at least an identifier. But there are many libraries who aren't aware of it, how to configure SSO right in the right way, and they are asking their IT department to set up a SSO connection, and then it could be that also names and emails are exchanged as attributes together with the authentication. So here comes the important thing, and which give us concerns about the privacy. So what we are looking for is to disclose personal information as less as possible. So we like the minimal disclosure policy. A person, and you can choose between a few options, but you have the most common, the most obvious is a persistent identifier, and you can also share other information like affiliation, etc. So that is the federated identity management. So when we see the concerns, there's a lot of information here on the slide, but in short, we could form together a group of persons who understand the problem, and in that way, federated identity management for libraries, FIM4L, was born. And just a few things I would like to stress is that we support the Stanford statement, and we cooperate with Seamless Access. So Seamless Access is quite new. It's more from the publisher side, and we are more from the library side. So it's FIM4L is a library-led initiative, and we are now a Libre working group with five people, and besides that we have a list of about 50 people in the email list worldwide. So that's great, and we described the problem in a document, our charter document. And based on that, we went out and and address the problems and solve solutions. And then you can read more about it at our website. It's www.fim4l, the number four, dus fim4l.org. And you can see more about Fim4L. And then we made a document, because one of the things we would like is, as libraries, is to have one point that we can refer to if we set up single sign-on connections, because there are so many publishers and there are so many different configurations, and we would like to have some policy about the best way to configure, the best manner to configure a single sign-on. So here our guidelines and recommendations document comes in to picture, and in that document we have written the what we think good recommendations how to configure single sign-on connections in the best way. So it's very worthy to read the documents, and there are a few things I will show you here from that document, which is open for comments right now. So I want to invite you to take a look at it and to comment on it. So you're welcome to do this. A few important things of the document of guidelines and recommendations is about the attribute release. So when one authenticates by the library, you know, you go to a publisher and you want to log in and you choose your library, and you are challenged with the login screen from your library, then you put your credentials in, and what then happens is the library shares some information, and the least information which the library has to share is an identifier. And we have three options in our recommendations, in fact, three recommendations. And those recommendations on you can see it here on the screen. The first one is an identifier that changes every time you visit the service provider. That's the most privacy protected solution. It's anonymous. It's an opaque identifier, transient. It changes every time, so the publisher is not able to know who's behind that identifier. That's the first one. The second one is a persistent identifier, and that's a pseudonymous identifier. And this is an interesting one, because what happens here is that the publisher who receives such an identifier can use the identifier, because it's the same when users are coming back. So when you choose the persistent identifier, then a publisher is able to build up a profile, and a publisher could ask additional information from the patron, from the user, and a user is free to give or not to give that additional personal information. So that's great, a great one. So that's our recommendations as library to use a persistent identifier. And on top of that, whether you choose one or two, especially for the second option, you can choose to have additional non-identifiable information, like an affiliation or from which faculty you are, or are you a student or staff, or that kind of things. But non-identifiable information. If one configures the connection in that way, if a library configures the connection with a publisher in that way, a user the identity, personal information from the user is protected in that way. So this was my short presentation. If you like, you can subscribe to our email list at our website. It's the same as fim4l.org, but it's we are not ready yet with our website. You can also go to the Liber website. Just enter fim4l in Google and you will find it. So that's my presentation. There's now time for questions, and I will stop the recording.